Sleep.
Need some right now.
Yeah. How long should you sleep for?
What is optimal?
How long should you sleep?
As we always give the answer to all of these questions, how long is a piece of string? It's very much dependent on the individual, but I suppose standard practice is more, most people would say 8 hours.
It's like 6 to 8.
Between 6 to 8 is a range. The hardest thing I find as well is, particularly if I have, if I've thought about like, I'm gonna go to bed at this time, and I'm gonna try and get X amount of hours of kip. If as soon as I'm trying to think about falling asleep, I won't fall asleep.
Yeah,
like, literally,
terrible.
I'm like, wired. Yeah. Like, because I'm trying to consciously do something, so my mind is like...
I think your brain like pokes you, doesn't it? I think it's like, it's one of those things where you're, because you know you've got to get up early. It's like when you go to the airport and you've got to get up really early. Your brain knows that you need to get to sleep and it just goes, ah, stay awake, stay awake. Yeah. And then the more you become aware of it, the more frustrated you get and the harder it is to sleep. And then you, it's just a vicious circle.
Have you guys noticed Ben's hair, by the way?
It's gone. Just went. Just woke up like...
Wet in
like
his sleep.
Yeah.
In his sleep.
Just woke,
didn't get his 6 hours optimal and his hair started
Exactly, yeah. That's it. It's a product of lack of sleep. I actually sleep all right though. I used to be terrible. I used to sleep really badly. I think being a personal trainer, it's hard to get your regular patterns established. You know, sometimes you might have a client cancel early in the morning and then you kind of think, I'll have the extra hour sleep.
Think that that's going to be a benefit, but then 9 times out of 10 you wake up feeling worse.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because of that. Just the nature of our job is it's early starts, late finishes, and a lot of the time, generally...
Middle of the day is quiet.
Yeah, so like you get a lot of trainers, they'll do early and late, and they'll have a split day, and they'll sleep in the middle, generally.
I never do that.
I've got kids.
Never do that, right.
Although Charlotte would say that I do... Sometimes I get home when I do it, but generally if I had an hour's kip, and it makes sense to what you were saying in terms of that hour and a half theory, I wake up and I feel absolutely horrific. It's like, I feel terrible. And then it affects my ability to then get to sleep later on in the evening as well, if I sleep throughout the day. So even then, even if that time was like I'm desperate to have some sleep, I should really kind of stop. But sometimes a nice siesta is quite nice, isn't it?
I can't nap. I just can't
really?
Nap. I try and get these like 8 minute windows where I'll say if I get home and I feel particularly tired, I'll have an 8 minute window, I'll turn the lights off, prop my feet up, lie back and just close my eyes, set a timer for 8 minutes and just see if I fall drift off. Like, and I never do. I've done this so many times, I've never once actually fallen asleep. And it kind of,
When you do that, do you feel better when you come out?
Yeah, I almost get as well. It kind of tells me that I can't, even if I wanted to, I couldn't go to sleep now. So I sit there and I'll think and I'll actually get agitated. If you want to get up and move, but like, oh God, how long is this time?
I've got to stay.
Yeah, and then I open my eyes and I actually feel it's quite good to almost try to clear your brain a little bit. That works. And I'm like you, if I did have a nap, it just messes up my sleep in the evening.
Yeah. I think, as opposed to you saying about you're quite a good sleeper, I've found recently I've definitely not been getting as good a sleep as I used to. And I'm not 100% sure what that would be. It's probably just increased stresses in your life, really. Very much like a lot of people. So, admittedly, I'm not a particularly good sleeper. When I'm asleep, I'm a deep sleeper. That can be said, but I struggle to switch off.
Yeah.
So I struggle to be able to actually doze off and get into sleep.
What's your routine like before, like the hour window before you go to bed?
Generally it's not great. I'm probably thinking, 9 times out of 10, I'm thinking about work before I go to sleep, which is cardinal sin that you'd say to any other client. It's like your goal is to, like you were saying, we were discussing earlier, weren't we? Turn your phones off so no electronics within an hour of you going to sleep. Not watching TV before you go to sleep and doze off, that kind of stuff. Generally, I'll be phone checking social media, not scrolling generally to see what other bunch of people are putting up, but generally looking at what we've been doing and work-related stuff. Or I'll be answering emails when I have a chance throughout the day. So generally, my evenings, when I get home, say at 10:30 at night, like everyone, you want to have something to eat, have something to eat that late at night. Generally, you're gonna have to digest. Your body's now working overtime. All those kind of things, really. So
you don't really have a set routine. Or...
No, because generally, my set my routine and my evenings are generally quite different throughout the week.
So where I'd start if you were a client?
Yeah, of course. And again, that's the thing. I think it's key to note these videos. What we're doing as well is I think there's this thing in the fitness industry that as personal trainers, everyone's perfect. And I think you'll agree with that. And that's something that we're kind of demystifying the bullshit. Is the fact that we are business owners. We do have families. We have the same responsibilities and the same things that affect our lives.
So it just so happen to be in and around.
We're just in and around fitness. So it's quite nice for people to get a little bit of insight into what we would do. So yeah, I'm open to some suggestions because sleep's very important. So,
I mean, you get up at fairly regular times, don't you?
Yeah, 5:30 every morning. I would doze for 10 minutes.
So I get rid of the dozing. Get rid of the dozing. Doesn't benefit you. Just makes it harder to get up. Get up. If you set your alarm for 5:30, get out of bed at 5:30.
So you're not like to have just a little snuggle?
No. I'd love to, but I don't.
You can't step up, sit up, I'm out.
Get up, yeah. I wake up, as soon as my alarm hits, I have two alarms. I have an alarm clock that lights up the room, like half hour leading up. That usually wakes me up.
Yeah.
And then it makes an audible noise. So I have that set like a couple of minutes after my actual alarm is on my phone. If I wake up by the thing, switch it off, get out, get up. But if not, I've got to get up because that alarm is such a horrible noise.
Is Lizzie up as well with you?
No, my wife's fast asleep.
And that lighting alarm doesn't wake her up?
No, she's sound sensitive and I'm light sensitive. So I'll wake up if there's a little blinking light on the TV. And she'll wake up if a mouse farts down the street. so you can't, yeah. It's a good combo. But like, I get up and I'll get straight up. But like, you've got that and that's regular.
That's really tickle with that.
But I think the she's got a really amazing sense of smell as well. But like, yeah, I think if you get up at a regular time, and that's always the hardest bit, right? It's that little bit of discipline. And if you do that, and it's early, no matter what time you go to bed, you'll get tired the night after. So if you get up at 5, because I get up at 5:30 in the morning, it gets like 9 p.m. and I'm like, that's why I don't PT after 9 p.m. because...
You're a zombie.
I'm a mess, yeah. Up until 9, I'm sharp as a tack, and then you hit 9, boom. So I don't PT till after 9 just because I need to really wind down from work. I appreciate that not everyone has that situation.
Yeah, but you've constantly made that decision.
Yeah.
You choose not to PT. Used to.
Yeah.
And realise that I'm not delivering the best hours of my day at the end of my day. So
it was more because it was harder to get up in the morning.
Yeah.
You know, if you finish I've done shift, before I was a personal trainer, I worked in hotels, I've done shift work and stuff like that I've never had a 9-to-5 job. But like that, what I mean that like running to going to sleep, I think would be probably more beneficial to you. You know, the fact that you've got your phone out, checking emails before you go to bed, it's like, nah. And it's really hard to...
That's what I was going to ask as well is, do you use your phone as an alarm? Because for a little while, I ditched my phone and I put it on charge downstairs, first thing. I put it downstairs and I went up to bed and I bought myself like an alarm clock. Mm. So, and that seemed to work a lot better because I wasn't checking my phone before I went to sleep. And I wasn't preoccupying my mind looking at stuff that was, I couldn't do anything to control at that time of the day anyway.
I'd say if you don't want to use your phone in bed, then don't use your phone in bed, regardless of what it is. And have it right next to me and go, I'm not going to use this.
Yeah, but again, it's like, there's no excuse. I'm not using this as an excuse. I find myself, I suppose a lot of people find themselves, just...
Well, I gave myself
like, one simple... My missus, for example, so again, Charlotte, before she goes to sleep, she'll be on her phone.
Yeah.
But she can quite easily... Just put her phone down and then turn over and she's out like a light.
Yeah, I can't.
For me, I'm like, I'll see something and I'll be like riled up because I'm like, what the fuck's that?
Yeah.
And I'll end up being like,
can't do anything
but
about
then,
it.
But then, yeah, I can't do anything about it, but then in the top of your head.
Everyone's
you know me, I'm very much I overthink things, which is a positive and a negative thing. Mm. So it's about trying to take away those things that are going to create that environment, really, I guess.
I think everyone has those things where they go to bed and something's keeping them up. And then when you wake up in the morning, you think about it and you're like, oh, that's not a problem at all. There's a really simple solution to it, or yeah. I'm worrying about something that's not happened yet or not going to happen. You're kind of weirdly irrational right before you fall asleep.
Yeah, probably because you're tired.
Yeah, because you're tired.
It's like my kids, if they're tired, and they're completely irrational.
And it's that prodding, stay awake, you know, you've got to go to sleep. So the kind of idea of preparing for sleep, and it doesn't have to be a big, like, you know, it's not like preparing for a set of back squat.
Like a routine.
But like getting into a, having sort of set, I've set like rules that I do, yeah, chalking up. But like, I have a set of rules that I won't. So if I don't check my emails after a certain time, just because I'm not prepared to write a long reply back to someone right before I go to bed. So I'll see it in the morning. If it's an issue at 9 p.m. at night, it'll still be an issue.
Yeah, because I've noticed that, because again, me and Andrew are terrible at it. We'll see something throughout a message. And again, it's not you being rude, you've made a personal choice.
I'm not checking the phone, yeah.
I do not reply to messages after this time.
Yeah. Instead of using, so because I'm not taking on any screens or anything like that, I just read. I do things like, yeah, so it's kind of looking for activities that I can do that don't require a screen before bed.
That's wicked.
So it could be stretching, you could foam roll. Foam rolling's really good for relaxing people. I know it's uncomfortable and stuff like that, but if you're gonna mobilize, it's not a bad time to do it right before bed. No one has like a massage and then is ready to go, like, have a fight.
Nah.
So you know, you come out and you're like, oh, that might have ached, but I feel kind of weirdly numb. Hop into bed, fast asleep. Listen to music. I don't know what, everyone's different, but just avoiding, like, social media is not gonna add any quality to your life from bed.
No, it's, yeah, we've had debates about social media over the last couple of weeks and whether it actually can potentially yield benefit to people in general, and people get more viewpoints of people's lives and stuff. But I suppose, like everyone, you end up just getting drawn to it. And again, it's all about routine, isn't it? Mm. It's the fact that I've just got into a routine that I'll get home, because I've got home and I've had a long day and maybe haven't eaten for a matter of hours, I'll then have a big meal before, or after I get in from work, and after having a big meal, then you have some time that you just want to be able to chill out a little bit, but then you end up doing that in front of the TV, and again, you're in front of the screen, and then you've got your phone next to you, and you've got someone messaging you. It's about just controlling that environment, and I think that seems to be something that you've got down
to. Yeah, it took a lot of time.
Took time, but it's also something that you proactively obviously looked at and go, all right, sleep's very, very important. It's something you talk about, or we talk about with our clients a lot. It makes it that you can relate that. You've gone through that process.
Yeah.
You've gone like, oh, well, these are the things that I've done to affect my sleep and improve my sleep quality. And they've worked.
Yeah.
How about you try these?
I think as well, if things like not checking your email, not watching TV an hour before you go to bed is difficult, then just do half an hour. You know, if before bed it's better, right? And then you,
steps.
Over time, you might buy a book. And you might really enjoy it, and then that might creep.
I'm notorious for starting books and never finishing books.
Yeah,
notorious for it because, but yeah, I just don't get into the book, which is 9 times out of 10, I'll end up just getting distracted with something else.
The Yorkshireman in me is like, I've spent this money, I am reading this book, even if it's terrible, I'll see it through because I've put my hands in my pockets, so it's getting tired. Red. Yeah,
Tyler's awesome.
Yeah. So that's one of the things I look at. I think also like the environment that you sleep in. You know, if your room's really hot or like your duvet's really hot, get a thinner duvet. Being cool tends to help.
Darkness as well.
Darkness, absolutely.
So it is a little bit of trial and error. Like I said, playing around with the temperature in the room, playing around with the thickness of your duvet.
And the best monitor of if you've had a good night's sleep is how you feel when you wake up.
Exactly.
If you wake up and you feel fresh, or you realise that if you get up and as soon as you get in the shower you feel pretty alert, and then you could approach work at 6 a.m. and you feel like you're in control and you're concentrating well, then that's a good sign, right? If you wake up and you feel sluggish, all you want to do is turn turn around and just go to sleep for another 2 hours. You can't concentrate, like focus, then you've not had a good night's sleep. Like, this is the thing with those fitness trackers. I had a client that had a Fitbit that tracked her sleep. And she was stressing out, but she wasn't getting optimal sleep that it was suggesting. And it's like, how do you feel when you wake up? She's like, I feel all right. Then don't worry about it. I guess we've thrown out enough things there. I think the key thing is try get a routine, a regular waking up time, and holding to that. Having a bit of a routine before bed so you prepare for sleep, and then just tracking it and going off how you feel.
I suppose the biggest one that I take away from this is trying to in terms of controlling that environment, but trying to stay away from screens and the lead up to bed.
Yeah, massive. And then lullabies, they're pretty good. Sing yourself.
What's your favourite lullaby?
Twinkle Twinkle Little Star.
Have you ever counted sheep? Counted sheep, maybe.
Counting, yeah, in Spanish, backwards. That's what I do.